not an hour, another day. But at this moment, with my arms outstretched.
You want to pick up a whole bunch of them. Is that all right? Amen. And let them come to the mother church. This is the mother church. Somebody say the mother church.
Mother.
Amen. That's what this is right here. So we just thank God. And thank God all of those members that have already come and still coming. Amen. To be part. Amen. When you come, you still no position change. You're who you are. You're the same person when you show up on Sycamore Street. Say amen.
Amen.
Amen. And we thank God for all of that. In a couple more weeks, I'll be preaching, and then we'll start with some power, fruits of the loops, and all that good stuff. Say amen. Is that all right? All right. Amen. So get that out of the way. I wrote something down. Cajun Bible School. I tell you about one of them. I don't know. It was so awesome this week. Wow. Amen. How many teachers just wore out? I didn't even teach a class, and I was wore out. Amen. We did right around 100 children every day. Amen. Amen. We just thank God for that. I made a statement to someone, and I'm not going to call evil's name, but I made a statement to someone this week and said, wow, maybe next year we're going to extend this a few more weeks. And that person then looked at me and answered, saying, are you crazy? We're extending this, you know, like I was teaching every class, like I was, you know, I'm eating and sitting at the desk, and you know, when I get tired, I go in the office, close the door up. You know, I'm gonna do this, you know, a few more weeks. You know, how many know sometimes you don't have to say a word? Amen. Hallelujah. But we thank God. We made you some different things, but it was a great success, and we thank God for Jeanette, the director. So, and ain't the right to join aboard to be a partner to help. Amen. 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 As you pull up today, the roof is looking a little bit different. Amen. Amen. It's looking a little bit different. Amen. Just take care of God's house, God will take care of yours. Amen. We thank God. I hope you're doing here. Too many leaks we wanted to patch. We say, well, you don't patch your house. So let's not pass God. Thank God for the disease. Amen. Leading the way. Turn us leading. Amen. Amen. Various fears. Amen. And going with the best. And that will be a blessing to us. We thank God for that. Amen. So now we just replace what we don't spend. That's all we want to do now. Is that all right? But it still looks good out there. It looks good to me. All right. Amen. All right, that's 5 minutes of the message, so the message was 20 minutes, 15 more minutes to go. Look at somebody tell them, 15 minutes to go. Give or take. All right. Amen. Thank you. Turn with me to the first book of the Bible. Man, I tell you, if the choir was singing like that, they would all be focused together. Amen. I tell you, we wouldn't even see it. All they need to be. Amen. All right. Sure, I'm with musicians who love all of them. Amen. All of the Larry for that.
Right here.
All right. Bring the booth everywhere. Amen. Flexible. Say amen. Flexible. Hallelujah. That's my cameraman down there, Jose. He shows some love. All right. All right. How many are going to have me preach? Amen. Genesis, the 13th chapter. We want to just talk a little bit about this, and then we want to move on out of the way. Amen. Genesis chapter 13. Verse 1, and we'll stop at verse number 4. And we're just going to survey and talk about it a little bit for this Father's Day. And let's begin reading now. And Abram went up out of Egypt, he and his wife, and all that he had, and Lot with him into the south. Abram was very rich in cattle, in silver, and which he had made Israel at first, and they are Abraham called to the name of the Lord. That's enough for the reading. This morning we want to just talk about a thought. Father Abraham's secret. You may be seated. There is something unique and, if you will use the term, mysterious about the lives of certain individuals. It seems like there is a select group of people that God has pulled out and pulled aside in order to show the world and the community how good he is. There is a select group of people, of persons, that God has decided to lay his blessings upon in a bountiful way. All of us are blessed, but there are some folk that it seems like God goes over and beyond in the blessings. And I'm not trying to be selfish, but I want to be one of them. Is there anybody here this morning that don't mind being blessed by the Lord? Like I said on last Sunday, but you got to understand that God got to know that I can trust you. That if I begin to give you the overflow anointing, that I can trust that you won't change, that you won't begin to think more highly of yourself than you ought to. Somebody said it's Abraham's secret. It seems that if you study Abraham, that from the very beginning when he met God and the covenant between God and Abraham became a reality, Abraham never stopped believing that what God said to him was the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. So help me God. Abraham believed the covenant, which was nothing but an agreement that God had made with Abraham, that Abraham, over there in the 12th chapter, I'm going to bless you. Has the Lord promised anybody, you know, that in your heart that he wants to bless you out of me? And you really believe that? And no matter how things look in the natural, that you just believe God at his word, that God promised me certain things, and I'm not going to take anything but what God promised, no matter what the storm may be, no matter how dark the cloud may seem in my life, God promised me sunshiny days. Come on now, somebody. And no matter what the enemy throws you away, you're not going to stop disbelieving God. Abraham had a secret. And every time he wanted something from God, and every time God began to do certain things, it's right here to read it. He would always, at one point in life, stop, pitch a tent, make an altar, and pray. That simply signifies that he never stopped his communication with God. How often do we go through things in life and for weeks upon weeks we don't even pray, we don't praise God like we used to, we don't talk to the Lord on a regular basis because of what you're going through. Abraham never stopped talking his communication, he never stopped existing, he never gave up believing that God gave me a covenant and was an agreement, and I just believe God. Touch somebody and tell them, I've got a secret to tell you. See, I ain't stopped praying yet. I mean, is there anybody here that may be going through something
But you're having to stop praying. Now, some folks are already beginning. I can see it many times. When it goes through something, they disappear from God's house for a while. When trouble comes, they don't praise God like they used to. When the word is out in the community that you're going through something, it seems like the praise level begins to diminish. But I somebody tell somebody, don't you stop giving God glory. I don't care how long it takes. I don't care what direction God will allow you to have to go through. If you believe God will bless you and bless you abundantly and in and everything and everybody that stays in your camp, you ought to make some noise. One of the first things that God told Abraham, I'm getting ready to bless you, but I need you to get out of the north, but I need you to go to the south. Man, I don't know why you're doing this to me, God, but if you say it, and if you're in my life, and all things work together for the good of them that love the Lord, I will just believe God. Somebody is going through something even right now, not because the devil is beating you up so bad, but because God got something better for you tomorrow than you have today. You better tell somebody, tell them, God got something better for me. So if your job is closing down, he got a better one for you. If your home is upside down, he got a better one for you. If you're facing foreclosure, he got a better one for you. If you're getting ready to pick up your automobile, he got a better one for you. If your friends have forsaken you, he got some better friends for you. If they're lying on you, he got something better for you. If your husband don't want you, he got another one for you. If your wife don't want you, he got another one for you. Somebody open your mouth and say, Abraham's secret. He never gave up on God. Can I read you? I got about 10 more minutes. Let me read you. Y'all may think I'm just making up this. In chapter 12, it says, the Lord has said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto a land that I will show you. You don't know what it's going to look like. But I'm gonna show it to you when you get there. Tell your neighbor, I don't know where I'm headed. But when I get there, God's gonna show it to me. See, but the secret is, you gotta keep on moving. You gotta decide, I ain't giving up on God. I'm gonna keep on moving, I'm gonna keep on reading, I'm gonna keep on studying, I'm gonna keep on trying to get deeper and deeper in the word the best that I can, because God got something for me. Abraham had to deal with this thing. Because first God said, listen, Abraham, I'm going to bless you, but you got to get out of that country. Thy country. You got to get away from what's comfortable to you and everything and everybody around you that makes you feel comfortable. See, you can't grow if you're always comfortable. A baby cannot be birthed into this world with the mother being comfortable all the time. Now, something can be a witness to that one. See, because the closer she gets to birthing something, the more uncomfortable it gets. Matter of fact, I don't know any of my actors. I've been looking at her walk, and I said, wow, she's walking, she's uncomfortable. She came in the service this morning, wobbling. You know, but she in God's house, and I'm still saying the same thing. Lord, let her bless her little service. Don't let nothing happen while I'm here. Don't do it, God, because I can't take it. You know, hallelujah, don't bring her to the altar, tell me lay hands on her, and something happens at the end of the night and noon. Hallelujah, somebody. But she looks a little uncomfortable. That's because she's getting ready to birth something. Anybody going through some discomforts in your life? Anybody going through a few things, a few pains right now? Well, you got to look up in your mind and understand, you're getting ready to birth something. I mean, every time God really gave me an overflow blessing, it came only after I had to deal with something or I had to go through something, but I held on to my integrity anyhow. I held on to my praise anyhow. I held on to my God. So you can get out of the country, get around your kindreds, get from your father's house, and your land that I will show you. And I will make thee a great nation. This is what I really like. And I will bless thee. Somebody say, he'll bless you. Touch your neighbor and tell your neighbor, God will bless you. See, somebody here needs to understand that God will bless you. I mean, don't fool me there. How many know God will bless me? I mean, take me on your neighbor and open your mouth and say, God will bless me. Well, I'm going to shut up. Y'all believe that one. And either I'll make you a great nation, and I will bless thee, and I'll make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. See, you cannot be a blessing until you are blessed. You cannot help somebody else until God gives you something to work with. So God is trying to get something in your hand, not just so you can show it off or so you can have all that you want, but so you can help somebody else. But if you catch hold of this thing, if you bless somebody else with the right motive, God will not let you go lacking for anything. He's not going to let you help somebody else and then you go around broke. He's going to let you feed the hungry and you ain't got no food on your table. Our job is to do what God wants us to do. God's job is to make sure I go lacking for nothing. Now, friends have left me down. Friends have turned their backs on me. Loved ones have said, I don't want to have nothing else to do with you. But God ain't never failed me. In 53 years, God has never failed me. I mean, if there's anybody that can be a witness, that even though I've been through some pain, God has never failed you. Job was so bad that Job said, don't you slay me? Yet shall I trust you? Anybody trust in God today? I mean, even though you might be going through something, so-called recession, but trust God anyhow. Trust somebody, tell God, get ready to bless me. So I can be a blessing. It's right here. In verse 3 and 10, and I will bless them that bless you. And I will curse them that curse you. And these shall all families of the earth be blessed. In other words, it ought to carry on. I know the reason is a little sad today, up and down because this is daddy's birthday. But you open the eyes and see the blessings of God. I mean, one man have caused so much to take place in just one little area. What would happen if all of us grab hold of that thing? That just because of my blessing, this is blessed, this is blessed, that is blessed, that one is blessed, that one is blessed. God is trying to let us know that your name will go way before, when you're dead, buried in your grave, our name will go on anyhow. Okay. Here you go, verse chapter 13. Abraham went out of Egypt, and they're telling him, go out of Egypt, I got something for you. Take your wife and all that you have, and take Lot with you, and go into the south. Now, y'all got to read this thing, on your spare time. I can't get it all to you. But God blessed Abraham so much that his blessing fell off on Lot. Y'all notice that? And it fell on Lot because every time Abraham moved, Lot was right there. Every time Abraham opened his mouth and gave wisdom, Lot was listening to him. See, many of us is missing some things, not because God don't want to bless you, but because you're around the wrong one. See, you got to be around somebody that God is already blessing, so the overflow blessing can fall on you. God blessed Abraham, and then God began to bless Lot. Matter of fact, he blessed Lot so much that Abraham and Lot couldn't stay in the same town. Man, I wish God could bless us so much that we have to say, I'm in Dinwiddie right now, but man, God will bless you so much, there ain't nothing else in Dinwiddie for my family. So what I got to do, I got to go to Prince George, I got to go to Petersburg, and I just go ahead and start buying off Petersburg and buying off Prince George, because you bless so much in Dinwiddie, you got that under control. Lot had to get out of here. Some of them, they got in an argument and all that. They had a disagreement, but the disagreement was the fact that you were blessed so much. You got so much stuff now, that the two of us can't stand, they can't stand the same damn. The folk in the city couldn't handle it. The folk in the country couldn't handle Abraham and Lot living in the same thing. And every time they looked at them, they're those two blessed folk. They're those two guys, them, but not on him. Their whole family is blessed. I mean, I like it when folks say, man, them brown are something else. I mean, you ought to feel good with it. Man, them bees is something else. See, that's a legacy. You know, but you want it to be a positive, because I've been hearing it before. You know, that he's something else. But it don't mean the same thing. Yeah, y'all understand what y'all saying? You don't want me to just make it too plain, because me and y'all say I'm talking about somebody. But you know, there's some folks that say, man, he's something else. That family's something else. Yeah, you know, I heard before they say, man, they something else. You know, then they're not. All right, okay. And Abraham was something very rich in cattle, in silver, and in gold. Now, where we get this thing, I'm almost finished, where we get this thing that the poor I am, the more holy I am, and the more godly I am. I mean, I don't know where it came from, but touch somebody and tell me you need to get rid of that. Because as a man thinketh in his heart, not just thinking in your heart, so is he. So how many folks think that you are nothing, you are nobody, you just pouring rain, don't put your hand, I'm wrong with you, you think that in your heart, but that's what's going to come to you. But is there anybody that's thinking in your heart that I'm somebody? I'm a child of God. Father Abraham is my dad. And everything that God, my daddy gave Father Abraham, that I can have some of the same things. I mean, we ought to want to reap some of the benefits of God. Jesus, poor Jesus, younger, poor Jesus. He did a survey. Came on TV. After many years, they did a survey, a questionnaire, whether Jesus had anything or not. And the argument was that Jesus was a very poor, humble, very person. But the research said, no, because during that time, there were only two classes of people. We got three classes today. We got poor, middle class, and then we got the rich. But during the time of Jesus, you were either poor or you were rich. There was no in-between. And the research says that Jesus was not poor, so he had to be rich. Everybody hung around. Most of the time, he had something. Peter, can I use your yacht? I've got to go on a missionary journey. And the yacht was so bad and so big that he had his own room. He had his own room, he had his bed, and I didn't know he had a pillow. Y'all do remember that story? He was asleep. And what do you sleep on? A pillow. You know, that's a cruise ship, y'all. I mean, some of y'all know you're going on a cruise. That was one of them ships. He had his own cabin. Laid back. Zacchaeus, come on out of that tree. I want to go home and I want to eat with you. Zach, who are you, Zacchaeus? I'm the tax collector of the town. I got plenty of money and plenty of revenue. Zacchaeus, come on down here. I need to talk to you. That's Jesus, y'all. You know, and then for those that really believe in your heart, and I don't want to hurt you, if you really believe that Jesus was poor and you want to be like Jesus, then my question is, why do you keep pulling up into the churchyard with that brand new car? I mean, if you really believe that Jesus was poor and you want to be just like him, you need to give that car to me. Somebody don't believe it, and then you ride a bicycle to the church or walk to church. Because you want to be like who? Jesus. I want to be like Jesus, everybody. But I want to be like him because he was the King of Kings. How many know he's the Lord of Lords? Let me give you these two things real quick. The reason Abraham had a secret, one of the things he always did was he prayed. Church, don't stop praying whatever you're going through. You know, whatever come your way, don't stop praying, because that's the only way to talk to God. His way of talking to us is talking to our spirit, talking to our heart, or talking to the Word. Your way of talking back to him is not reading the Word. That's just talking to you. To talk to him, you got to pray. Any prayers in the house? Well, that means you talk to the Lord. You know, little prayer, little time talking to the Lord. No prayer, you don't ever talk to God. God is just blessing you because of the prayers of somebody else. Get it in your head. You got to talk to God for yourself. Nothing's going right for me, preacher. Nothing's going right for me, pastor. When the last time you prayed? You know, for certain things, I can't do for you. But I know my Heavenly Father is able to do anything but fail. So everybody say he's great. Then he had a purpose. You got to have a purpose in life. My purpose is to please God. My purpose is to bless the Lord. My purpose is to be better to tomorrow than I am today. My purpose is to leave my footprints in the sand. And whatever I've been dealt, for me to take what I've been dealt, change it around, and get a royal flush. That's for you all. Cartwheel. You know, some of y'all don't know nothing about that, you know. But some of us that know we don't ride the car, you know, we're gonna get that royal.
Okay, all right.
And then Abraham kept on pushing. I'm on through. He kept on pushing. Keep on pressing on, saints. I mean, be not careful, but kind of limit how much news you keep listening to. And don't get enough word. Because that news will depress. Any time they'll put on the news that they're upset because a man killed a fly. I don't need to listen to that station too often. Because then you're dwelling on the fact that I'm waving a fly off my face so it won't get in my nose or in my mouth. And I get a germ and then it land on my hand and my reflexes are so quick that I kill the fly. That ought to be a compliment. The brother is in such good shape. Now some of y'all may not think it much too, but some of y'all can't kill no fly with your hand. You know, you can barely kill him with a fly swatter. Come on now. You know, that's why you got the rain in the kitchen. Huh? That's why the fly flying around, you spraying. And you're missing it, it's back all on the wall. Because the reflex is not what it used to be. But the brother killed. Okay, y'all heard that news, right? Okay, for those who don't know what I'm talking about, what are you talking about, a fly? They got on the new President Obama pitching him killing a fly. So then they didn't want to write him, they didn't want to argue, why did you kill that poor old fly? I want to hear something about how good God has been. And that I can do anything but fail. That God got a place for me that nobody else can get to but me. God got something for all of us here today. But you got to recognize that he got something with just your name on it. And sometimes God got to eliminate some things out of your life, whether you like it or not, so you can get to the next level. Abraham, get out of the country. Get around your hanging partner, because I've got a place for you.
Not a second or another minute, not an hour or another day, but at this moment with my arms outstretched, I need you to make a way, as you have done so many times. Through a window or an open door, I stretch.